Good morning, students. Now, our subject is Engineering Geology, fourth unit. Our topic is Earthquake Terminology, Classification, Causes and Effects, Shield Areas and Seismic Wells, Richter Scale Intensity, Precautions of Building Constructions in Seismic Areas. These all aspects are we are discussing in this class. Guys, now actually just we are going to discuss the earthquakes. But before going to that, what is earthquake? What is earthquake? So guys, earthquakes is nothing but a constitute one of the worst natural hazards which often turn into disaster causing widespread destruction and losses to human life. The effects of earthquake vary upon the magnitude and intensity. Earthquakes occur every now and then all around the world, except in some places where earthquakes occur rarely. The devastation of cities and towns is one of the effects of earthquake. What is earthquake? An earthquake is the result of a sudden release of energy in the Earth's crust that creates seismic waves. The seismic activity of an area refers to the frequency, type, and the size of earthquakes experienced over a period of time. For example, if you throw stone in a pond of still water, series of waves are produced on the surface of water. These waves spread out in all directions from the point where the stone strikes the water. Similarly, any sudden disturbances in the Earth's crust may produce vibration in the crust, which travel in all directions from point of disturbances. Guys, terms related to earthquake. Here, focus or hypocenter, epicenter. Focus or hypocenter, epicenter. These are all the two words. Guys, focus. Hypocenter means focus is the point on the fault where rupture occurs and the location from which seismic waves are released. Epicenter is the point on the Earth's surface that is directly above the focus, the point where an earthquake or underground explosion occurs. Guys, for example, earthquake is happened here. This is the focus and the exact location of the above of the surface of the Earth is called an epicenter. But earthquakes always occur at the fault zone. So fault line. A fault line is the surface trace of a fault, the line of intersection between the Earth surface.
Fault plane
are the cracks or sudden slips of the land. Fault slip. A fault scarp is the topographic expression of faulting attributed to the displacement of the land surface by movement along faults. Here guys, like the focus, this is the epicenter, this is the fault, and this is the fault scarp, this is the wavefront. From this figure, this is the focus means earthquake happened on the fault line. So the exact location from the focus to the surface of the earth is called the epicenter. This is like the waves. Here circles is there. This is the circles is nothing but the wavefronts. So focus, epicenter, fault and wavefronts. Here fault scarp.
and the causes of earthquakes. The
primary causes of an earthquake is faults on the crust of the earth. A fault is a break or a fracture between two blocks of rocks in response to stress. This movement may occur rapidly in the form of an earthquake or may occur slowly in the form of creep. Earth scientists use the angle of the fault with respect to the surface known as the deep and the direction of slip along the fault to classify faults. Classification of faults: normal fault and thrust fault. Normal fault means a deep slip fault in which the block above the fault has moved down relative to the block below. Thrust reverse fault: a deep slip fault in which the upper block above the fault plane moves up and over the lower block. That's here, this is the normal fault. This is the thrust or reverse fault. Strike slip fault: a left lateral strike dip fault. For example, it is one on which the displacement of the far block is to the left when viewed from either side. A right lateral strike slip fault: it is one on which the displacement of the far block is to the right when viewed from either side. Some major causes of earthquakes and basic of its causes are surface causes, volcanic causes, and tectonic causes. Here, guys, surface causes: great explosions, landslides, slips on a steep coast, dashing of sea waves, avalanches, railway trains, heavy trucks. Some large engineering projects cause minor tremors. Some of them are man-made, others are natural. So, volcanic cause: volcanic eruptions produce earthquakes. Earthquakes may precede, accompany, and frequently follow volcanic eruptions. They are caused by sudden displacement of lava within or beneath the earth crust. There are two general categories of earthquakes that can occur at a volcano: volcano tectonic earthquakes and long period earthquakes. Tectonic causes: structural disturbances resulting in the parts of the lithosphere is the main cause of this type of earthquake. Most of the disasters earthquakes belong to this category and occur in areas of great faults and fractures. Sudden yielding to strain produced on the rocks of accumulating stress causes displacements, especially along old fault zone known as great transform faults. Here, plate boundary overview: waves produced due to earthquake. Here, guys, seismic waves produced due to earthquakes are basically divided into two major types: body waves and surface waves. The above picture is the here, guys, the body waves. This is the surface waves. Body waves. Body waves travel through the interior of Earth as they leave off the focus. Body waves are further divided into following types: primary P waves and the secondary S waves. Here, guys, this is called the P waves, this is the S waves, this is the surface waves. Primary waves as secondary waves. Primary waves, high frequency. Secondary waves also S waves, or P means primary waves, S means secondary waves. So both are in the high frequency, both are in the short wavelength, but primary P waves are the longitudinal waves, secondary waves are the transverse waves. So what we observe, guys, this is also very very important in seismic survey also. P waves and S waves has the high frequency and a short wavelength, P waves and S waves, but P waves are the longitudinal waves, S waves are the transverse waves. Here P waves pass through both solids and liquids, but here cannot move through liquids. Oh guys, this is the major point we have to observe here, guys. This is the fourth point is the important to us. P waves passing through both solids and liquids. P waves is nothing but a longitudinal waves or a primary waves. So primary waves can pass through both solids and liquids, but secondary waves or S waves cannot move through the liquids. This principle gives the more information to us about the core and litho and core and asthenosphere something. So passing through both solids and liquids in the P waves, S waves cannot move through the liquids. So, but it can move through the solids. Okay. And moves forwards and backwards as it is compressed and decompressed. Move in all directions from their sources. Okay. But P waves moves only backwards. P waves forwards and backwards as it is compressed and decompressed. But here, guys, secondary waves move in all directions from their source. P wave is faster. S wave is more slower than the P wave. So P is the faster and S is the slower, P. P wave is faster. S wave is more slower than P wave. First P wave arrive. After P wave, S wave is arrive. S wave is arrive. Okay. Guys, from this figure, we have to identify, again, I will tell you these things because this is the most important. Both the primary P waves and S waves are having the high frequency and both are belongs to the short wavelength. P wave is the longitudinal wave and S wave is the transverse wave. Here, S wave passing through both solids and liquid, but S wave only cannot move through the liquids. So move forward and backward as it's compressed and decompressed. Move forwards and backwards as it compressed and decompressed. But moving all directions from their source. P wave is faster, S wave is slower than the P waves. First P wave arrive, secondary S wave is the second. After P waves, S wave is arrive. Guys, surface waves. Surface waves travels parallel to the earth surface, and these waves are slowest and most surface waves. Surface waves travels parallel to the earth surface, and these waves are slowest and most damaging. What they do? Surface waves travels parallel to the earth surface, and these waves are slowest and most damaging. Surface waves are divided into following types: Low waves and Rayleigh waves. Rayleigh waves and Low waves. Here, Rayleigh waves and Low waves. Guys, if we observe the directions of the energy here, Rayleigh wave is like in this way, and the body waves, Rayleigh wave and low wave, and Rayleigh wave and low wave. Okay. Guys, the differences between the low waves and Rayleigh waves, low waves, guided waves, both are the guided waves, and the displacement is parallel to the free surface. displacement is perpendicular to Love wave displacement. Love wave is faster, Rayleigh wave is slower. Causes horizontal shifting of that surface. Ground move in circular motion. Strength of earthquake. The intensity and the strength of an earthquake is measured on a Richter scale. The scale invented by Charles Richter, California, USA in 1935. Which category is earthquake on the basis of energy released? Definition, the logarithm to base 10 of the maximum seismic wave amplitude recorded on a standard seismograph at a distance of 100 kilometers from the earthquake epicenter. Scientists measure the strength of earthquakes using machines, using mechanics known as a seismographs. Seismology or seismology is the scientific study of earthquakes and the propagation of elastic waves through the earth. Guys, here group and magnitude. Very minor is nothing but the less than 3.0, and minor 3 to 3.9, and light 4 to 4.9, moderate 5 to 5.9. Strong 6 to 6.9, major 7 to 7.9, great 8 and higher magnitude, it is the great earthquake. Amount of energy released during different earthquakes. For example, intensity of earthquake on Richter scale, energy release amount of TNT. TNT is using the preluded, it's a matter using in the mind something to detonate. For example, intense on earthquake on the Richter scale, 170 grams TNT explosion. If intensity of earthquake on Richter scale 2, the energy release 6 kilograms. If the intensity scale is 3, 179 kilograms of TNT. And if Richter scale is 4, 5 metric tons, 5,179 metric tons, 6, 5,643 metric tons, 7, 1,79,100 metric tons, 7.5, 1 megaton, 8.1,564,300 metric tons, amount of TNT if detonates, how energy is released, that energy released on the Richter scale 8. Seismometers, the measurement of earthquake. Guys, seismometers are instruments that measure motions of the ground, including those of seismic waves generated by earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, and other seismic sources. Seismometers may be deployed at the earth surface in shallow walls, in boreholes, or underwater. This is the seismograph. Imagine types of zones. Guys, here the earthquake zoning map of India divides India into 4 seismic zones based on the observations of the affected area due to earthquake in India, divided into 4 types of zones. Zone 2, this is said to be the latest active seismic zone. Zone 3, it is included in the moderate seismic zone. Zone 4, this is considered to be the high seismic zone. Zone 5, it is the highest seismic zone. Guys, here zone 1, zone 2, zone 3, zone 4, zone 5. the colors are indicates their zones. Guys, so our Hyderabad are higher guys, Visakhapatnam, and these are the Andhra Pradesh and Telangana belongs to the zone 1. So earthquake prediction is usually defined as the specification of the time, location and the magnitude of future earthquake within stated limits. But some evidence of upcoming earthquakes are following. Unusual annual behavior, water level in wells, large scale of fluctuation of oil flow from oil wells, foreshocks or minor shocks before major earthquake, temperature change, uplifting of earth surface, change in seismic wave velocity. Effect of earthquakes, loss of life and property, damage to transport system, roads, railways, highways, airports, marine, damage to infrastructure, changes of chances of floods, develop cracks in dams, chances of fire short circuit, communications such as telephonic wires and damaged water pipes, sewers are disrupted. Economic activities like agriculture, industry, trade and transport are severely affected. Landslides also affect of the earthquake and shaking and ground rupture. Fires and soil liquefaction, tsunami and floods. Earthquake safety rules. If you are guys, this is not a mandatory. Guys, guys, here guys, so up to now we discussed guys, so up to now we discussed earthquakes terminology, earthquakes classification, earthquakes causes and effects, and the Richter scale intensity also we discussed. Now the shields are shield areas and the seismic belts. Shield areas and seismic belts. Guys, here seismic belts are those places where earthquakes occur frequently. Shield areas are those places where earthquakes occur either rarely or very mildly. Occurrence of an earthquake in a place is an indication of underground instability there. Statistics have revealed that nearly 50% of earthquakes have occurred along mountain ridges and 44% of earthquakes along steep coasts. The study of recorded earthquakes shows that they take place on land most frequently along two well-defined seismic belts. Circumspeak belt, which accounts for 68% of earthquake occurrence. Mediterranean belt accounts 21% of earthquake, which extends east-west from Portugal, Himalayas, and Burma, with a branch through Tibet and China. This is the guys, Pacific Oceans, Atlantic Ocean and Indian Ocean, and these colors, red color circumpacific belt indicates the, and the Himalayan and Mediterranean belt is the green color, mid-oceanic ridge system is the third color. So Richter scale, already I explained, but again I will do the Richter magnitude scale, also Richter scale. assigns a magnitude number of quantify the energy released by an earthquake. The Richter scale developed in the 1930s is a base 10 logarithmic scale, which defines magnitude as the logarithm of the ratio of the amplitude of the seismic waves to an arbitrary minor amplitude. In 1935, the seismologist Charles Francis Richter and Benno Gutenberg of the California Institute of Technology developed a future Richter magnitude scale, specifically for measuring earthquakes in a given area of study. The Richter scale was successor in the 1970s by the moment magnitude scale. This is now the scale used by the United States Geological Survey to estimate magnitudes for all modern large earthquakes. Here, guys, already explained the Richter scale. Zero here, scale 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, up to 8. 8 is the maximum. And guys, an earthquake of magnitude 5 may cause damage within a radius of 8 kilometers, but that of magnitude 7 may cause damage in a radius of 8 kilometers, and that of 8 over a radius of 250 kilometers. And construction of buildings in seismic areas, precautions and precautions measurements. Guys, buildings should be founded on hard bedrock only and never on loose soils or fractured rocks. This is because loose ground settles due to earthquake vibrations. Buildings situated in cuttings on hillsides near sheet slopes always suffer more when an earthquake occurs. For large buildings, raft types of foundations are desirable. Square foundations are more stable. Here, guys, a square foundation, stable, compacted field extension of the influence depth. This is the stress bulb. Here, influence depth ID 2 into 80. Here, only the soil grains inside this stress bulb feel the weight of the foundation. And different parts of buildings should be well tied together so that the whole structure behaves like a single unit to the vibrations. Only rich cement, mortar, and reinforced concrete should be used. Buildings with irregular shapes, with wings, verandas, porches, and all structures should be avoided. Buildings should have RCC roofs, and they should be designed not to yield to lateral stress. Resonance is the important factor if the period of vibration of a structure is the same as that of the foundation rock, it will collapse because of the resonance effect. Civil engineering considerations in the seismic areas. Seismic areas are the places which experience earthquakes frequently. Therefore, constructions in seismic and aseismic areas differ in terms of their design. So a civil engineer should only think of making his constructions immune to earthquakes. It is possible to find the difficulties by predicting some crucial factors, the exact place of earthquake occurs, the duration of the earthquake, the direction of movement of the ground at the time of earthquake. Guys, here, I want to tell you the guys, so earthquake safety risk, what we are do. If you are in house, don't use a lift for getting down from building after in the earthquake times. Be prepared to move with your family. If you are in a shop or school or office, don't run for an exit. Take cover under a desk or table. Move away from window glasses. Do not go near electric point and cable. Keep away from a weak portion of the building and false ceiling. If you are outside, avoid high buildings, walls, power lines, and other objects that could fall and create block. Don't run through streets. If possible, move on to an open area away from hazard, including trees. If you are in vehicle, stop in a safe open place. Remain inside vehicle, close windows, doors, and vents. After an earthquake, keep calm, switch on the transistor radio, and obey instructions. Keep away from beaches and low banks of river. A huge wave may sweep in. Do not re-enter badly damaged buildings and do not go near damaged structures. Turn off the water, gas, and electricity. Do not smoke, light match, or use a cigarette lighter. Do not turn on switches. There may be gas leak or short circuit. If there is any fire, try to put it out or call fire brigades. And do not drink water from open containers without having examined. If you aware of people have been buried, tell the rescue teams, do not rush and try not to worsen the situation. Avoid places where there are loose electric wires and do not come in contact with any metal object. Eat something, you will better and more capable of helping others. Do not walk around the streets to see what is happening. Keep the streets clear so rescue vehicles can access the roads easily. Okay, guys, thank you for all of your patience. In next class, I will teach the next topic. Thank you.